So today is a very auspicious day. Today is the Dand Mahotsav Leela of Raghunath Das Goswami. So the Nityananda Prabhu, he bestowed his mercy upon Raghunath Das Goswami. So Raghunath Das Goswami in Bengal, Hooghly Jila, Adi Saptagram, Keshtapur. The village name is Keshtapur. So there, he appeared there. His father, his father name was Hiranya Govardhan Majumdar.
Ребят, подождите, сейчас дальше Сундари принесет трансмиттер и будет русский перевод, окей?
Number, which number?
95.
So he has got birth in that very rich family, and since his childhood, so he was so much detached from this material world, because spontaneously there is a spontaneous detachment. First one is Markat Vairagya, Swabhavik Vairagya, detachment. So when we describe the character of Raghunath Das Goswami, so he was totally detached from material sense gratification. So at the time of his childhood, he has learned all the shastras. and especially he got the association of Haridas Thakur. At his house, Haridas Thakur used to came there. That's why he got the association of Haridas Thakur. He used to chant 3 lakhs name per day. So we get the impression of with the sadhu. By the association of sadhu, we get impression. Even he was the nitya associate of Radha Krishna Leela. Raghunath Vilas Rati Manjari. He was the Rati Manjari in Radha Krishna Leela. Still, in this Prakat Leela, he was showing Sulabhna Soi. So Tulsidas ji in Ramcharitmanas is describing this. Vinu satsang. Until we get the association of sadhu, we cannot get the wisdom. We cannot discriminate which is what is right, what is bad. So how we get the satsang? So by the mercy of the Lord. So last previous many words Sukriti, when collected, then we get the association of sadhu, and in the association of sadhu we get the bhakti, and by the bhakti we can attain Bhagwan. So that's why Raghunath Das Goswami, the characteristics of Raghunath Das Goswami, see, he got the association of Namacharya Haridas Thakur. And if somebody has developed, manifested bhakti in his heart, so he spontaneously get the detachment from the material sense gratification. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is clarified, if bhakti manifests somebody's heart, so spontaneous, there are three kinds of symptoms we can see in his heart. What? Bhakti means he will get the service tendency. So spontaneous, he will get the service tendency for Krishna. So he will realize Bhagwan in his heart. So he will be so much detached from all kinds of material sense enjoyment. Just like when someone is hungry and he getting the food, so he gets satisfied. First is we will be satisfied from the hungerness, and getting every bite, so we get power. So at least we get the satisfaction, we get so much power in our body. In the same way, when bhakti manifests in somebody's heart, these all symptoms seems in the sadhak. Just like Maharaj told Chitbal. So he got the Chitbal in his heart. So by the impression of this satsanga, that's why Raghunath Das Goswami, we have seen in the characters of Raghunath Das Goswami that how he got the association of Namacharya Haridas Thakur, and by the consequence of that he got so much detached from this material world. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas and he went to Advaita Acharya house at Shantipur, so at that time Raghunath Das Goswami, he met with Mahaprabhu there, and so he prayed so much to Mahaprabhu for being with him. What Mahaprabhu said?
अंतरनिष्ठ करो लोक व्यवहार चिरातेष्ट तुम्हाई करिवे
Mahaprabhu said, don't do Markat Vairagya. Markat Vairagya means just like monkey, he sits very quiet. When somebody came, so he snatch something from him. So in this way, don't do Markat Vairagya. If you have Vishayavasana for desiring sense gratification in your heart, so always take the Vishaya which is favorable for bhajan. Always accept the Vishaya bhog which is favorable for bhajan. So we should accept the favorable thing and the unfavorable we have to give up. So we have seen this all things in the character of Raghunath Das Goswami. That's why Raghunath Das Goswami, he told to Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu told to Raghunath Das Goswami, don't do Markat Vairagya. First, what you have to do, you have to form faith in your heart towards the feet of Guru Vaishnava. We must have done the tendency of service of Guru Vaishnava. And externally, so we have to deal with all the peoples very nicely. We should live very neutral, detached from this world. Most of the time we should give to the service of Bhagwan. Swadhanam. Then you will get the Bhagwan. By the service you will get Bhagwan. So this is the greatest lesson of Mahaprabhu. So I am just telling few words. I will tell something about bhajan rasa too. That's why Raghunath Das Goswami was told to when Krishna bestows his mercy upon you, so spontaneously you will left everything and will stay with me at Jagannath Puri. So according to the instruction of Mahaprabhu, so he went to him and many times he tried to give up the household life. So he took the initiation, Yadunandana Acharya. He took the initiation of Yadunandana Acharya. So he wrote the pranam mantra to Yadunandana Acharya. So he wrote this Ramran to Yadunan Acharya, his guru. So by the mercy of him, I got the Shrestha mantra, topmost mantra, Gopal mantra, Gayatri mantra, all the mantra, Harinam. So I get the shelter of Sachinandan Gaurhari's feet, and especially Swarupa Damodara Raya Ramanand, Giriraj Govardhan, Radha Kund. So I got all these things. So that's why I am so much obeisance of my Gurudev. So in the shloka he is describing like this. And then Raghunath Das Goswami, his father saw that he is again and again giving up the household life. So what to do now? Oh, so we should get married with him. So there was a beautiful lady like Apsara. He got married, but his mind was not engaged in his household life. So what he did? So he made a plan that how can I meet with Mahaprabhu. Then what he did? He was staying in this world, very detached from this material world, because the people cannot understand he is performing bhakti. Externally, as Mahaprabhu told him, externally you should deal the people very nicely, but internally you should perform bhakti. So first his father was tying him after with many things. So he have told the people, please keep an eye on him so he cannot walk away from here. But Raghunathas Goswami, what he did? So he was pretending to be people very nicely that, and internally he was worshipping bhakti. He has so much nishtha towards Mahaprabhu. What he did next? So he went to, especially to the day of Panihati. So Dandita Mahotsav of Raghunathas Goswami, the pastime of Raghunathas Goswami, the Dhan Mahotsav. So Raghunathas Goswami went there. So Nityananda Prabhu, he chastised him very respectfully that you are thief. He said, Chora, you are thief. I will punish you. What you did? Why he said Chora to him? Because Nityananda said, look, that Gaurasundar is my property. He is my heart property. And you would like to get Gaurasundar. So you have to take the order of me. Without getting the instruction of somebody's possessions, getting is that is called thief. That person is called. So you should ask me first. That's why Nityananda Prabhu, in this way, he was saying, you are thief. Because Gaurasundar is my property and you are stealing him without my order. How you can get him without my order? So what is the meaning? Nityananda is akhanda guru tattva. So without the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, we cannot get the mercy of Gaurasundar. Krishna pave charan. So this is the shiksha was giving to by Nityananda Prabhu. It is true. Forgetting the Radha Krishna, one and only you have to take the shelter of Nityananda Prabhu. That's why it is saying. Narottam Das Thakur, he is saying in his prayers. When we will get the best of his mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, we will get the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. Then my all the material desire will be destroyed gradually. When I will be free from this material desires, my heart is totally engaged in this sense gratification. But if somebody get the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, so all the dust or mud will be destroyed or removed gradually. Until we get the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu or the Valdeva Prabhu mercy, so how we can be free from all these material desires? When your heart will be pure, so in the pure heart, Sandani, Samvid, Haladani will manifest in your heart. Then we will get the darshan of transcendental Vrindavan Dham. So now I tell the further katha. Nityananda Prabhu, so he caught to Raghunath Das Goswami, and when Raghunath Das Goswami doing pranam to him, what internal Prabhu did? So which is rare for the Brahma lotus feet, so he has put his lotus feet to the Raghunath Das Goswami. Maybe you have seen the Chitrapat, the picture that how Nityanand Prabhu his very soft and lotus feet putting on the head of Raghunath Das Goswami. What does it mean? Without the mercy, what is the mean that without the mercy of Nityanand Prabhu, all the obstacles of this material world will be go away. So after that, Nityanand Prabhu, so he said that very softly that I will punish you. What kind of punishment? You have to serve all the Vaishnav. Because today this is the on this day what you have to serve. So you have to chivda. So you have to flat rice and the yogurt. So you have to distribute and feed everybody. Vaishnav serve Vaishnavs. Guru serving, Vaishnav serving. Hari Guru Vaishnav. So when you serve Hari Guru Vaishnava, all the obstacles will be go away. That's why Nityanand Prabhu very respectfully, very affectionately, he told, please serve the Vaishnava. Raghunath Das Goswami was thinking, my father has so much money. He was, what kind of his father is? He has so much possessions. His father was Vaishnapraya. And one Vishapraya. One is Vaishnapraya and another is Vishapraya. It seems like Vaishnapraya is topmost, but it is not like that. Somebody seems like Vaishnav, but he is very miser. He cannot spend a little bit money. That's why he is called. He is Vaishnapraya. He looks like Vaishnava, but actually is not pure Vaishnava. And another is Vishayapraya. He looks like Vishay, materialistic person, just like Pundarik Vidyanidhi. You have heard the katha of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. He looks like Vishayapraya. Rai Ramaradi, they externally seems like Vishayapraya. Srinivas Thakur. All the assets of Mahaprabhu, they seems like very materialistic. It seems like externally materialistic, but actually their heart is full of bhakti, full of Krishna prema. So that's why we call two kinds of person, Vishayapraya and Vaishnapraya. And Raghunath Das Goswami father, his father and uncles was look like Vishayapraya, Vaishnapraya. He was thinking that we should use their money in the service of Hari Guru Vaishnav. Bhagwan, the Lord has given us money, so we should, how they can spend the money in the Hari Guru Vaishnav service. So he was so much, Raghunath Das Goswami was too much pleased that time. And he gave the news to his father, then his father sent the money to him. And by that money, he buy the flat rice, yogurt, milk, and it is described very nicely in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Very nicely described is there in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. In the hot milk they have mixed up flat rice and banana yogurt, so there is no need to mix the water, mixing water in that. So in the hot milk they mixed up flat rice and then yogurt and then banana.
एक थोड़ा दही
no problem. So they buy many bananas from the market. So Uma Mataji telling is there a mango time. So they bought mango. So Sandesh is a very delicious or favorite sweets of Bengal. These people doesn't know. So the Sandesh is very tasty. So when we get the name of Sandesh, we get water in our mouth or tongue. Khati Sandesh is very, very tasty. And they have mixed up everything, each and everything. One pot. What was they made? An offer to Thakurji. So it is also described there. So he offered this offered three plates, this one for Mahaprabhu, one for Nityananda Prabhu, and one for Advaita Acharya. When they offered, so what happened? Mahaprabhu himself came there. So he came from Jagannath Puri, because Mahaprabhu has promised after, before the sannyas, he promised. So he gave the he promised to all the Nadiya's peoples that I will stay at five place, Sachir Mandire. I will stay with always Sachi with my mother Sachi Mata, in the invisible form. And second, when Nityananda Prabhu will dance, so I will stay there. And when Advaita Acharya called me, Advaita Acharya Avani, Advaita Acharya called me, so I will be there in Srinivas Angani, in the courtyard of Srinivas Angan. I will be there. When Srinivas got the news that Mahaprabhu has got taking sannyas and he will be go away from here, so Srinivas was crying. So Mahaprabhu promised to Srinivas that I will be stay at your home always. And the fifth one is Raghavendra Gire. So in the nearby Panihati, at the bank of Yamuna, Raghav and her sister Damayanti. So hearing the tendency of service of these kinds of people, your heart will be mentored that how they have so much affections. When Mahaprabhu taking sannyasi went to Jagannath Puri, what did it? For 1 year, Mahaprabhu was taking all kinds of stuff. Mucus. That's why. There is one kind of. अरे बाबा ये तुम्हारा मोबाइल तो बकवास है डब्बा मोबाइल इज जस्ट लाइक डब्बा आज व्हाट इज सेइंग ही ड्राई वन लीव्स व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सब्जी आई डोंट नो व्हेन इट बिकम्स ड्राई सो इट इज लिटिल बिट बिटर एंड वी दे सोक इनटू द वाटर एंड नेक्स्ट डे यू विल ड्रिंक दैट All the obstacles of your stomach will go away. Your stomach will be clean. So what they used to do? So they take these kinds of jute leaves. They used to take it and dry it, and used to take for Mahaprabhu. Even it is written, Mahaprabhu was not using all these things when after his Nitya Kriya. He used to make a paste of the sands, just like we chana. I don't know chana, flour mills, flour na atta. Are flour. Mahaprabhu was not using the soap, oil, and everything. But what he saw, So he, they were all bringing all little, little things to him. And many kinds of stuff, like food stuff, they used to take for Mahaprabhu. And they used to make many kinds of pickles for 1 year to Mahaprabhu, which will not be destroyed in 1 year. So they were preparing many kinds of sweets because somebody has love, so they used to all these kinds of things. And who is detached, so they think I am detached from this world, you are also. You are Vairagi and I am also Vairagi. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is described that 2-3 pages described like this, that what kinds of things they were bringing for Mahaprabhu. And they used to live for 4 months in the Chaturmas at Mahaprabhu place. And they used to ask the servant of Mahaprabhu, Govind, so have you given this verse or these things to Mahaprabhu or not? They used to ask to Govind these all things. And if he hasn't given to them, so they ask, oh, please give to them. So they have this kinds of tendency of service, so much affection towards Mahaprabhu. So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Huh? So at the bank of Yamuna. So there is a place of Raga Pandit. Maybe you will go there, so you will be astonished how beautiful place is that. Who has been there place, Raga Pandit place? Shashikala Devi. Have you been there to Panihati? Very nice, beautiful place. So now we have to finish. So, and then Nityanand Prabhu, when he was doing the kirtan, so what he saw, Sakshat Sachinandan Gaurhari himself appeared there. So who has loved, they will take the darshan. Not everybody took the darshan, but who has love in their heart, so they took the darshan of Mahaprabhu that time. Who has the love in their heart? So he saw himself, the Mahaprabhu is there. And he accept all this food stuff there. And after that, they perform Nam Sankirtan and Nityanand Prabhu. After taking the prasad, Mahaprabhu Nityanand Prabhu's ucheshka was given to all. So even there were so many people collected there, like even Devta also take place in that festival. So why they don't take place there? Because where Nityanand Prabhu and Mahaprabhu ucheshka is distributing, so who won't take that? And there is all everywhere was new. Spread. Even there was not a place to put your feet. Some people were staying at the Yamuna, Ganga. So they were taking the pot and taking food stuff in that pot. It is described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita very nicely. So when all the food stuff finished, so what Raghunath Das Goswami buy again all the things. So that's why we should remind this pastime on this day. This Dand Mahotsav, the Chira Mahotsav it is called. So we remind that pastime how Raghunath Das Goswami, he got the mercy of Nityanand Prabhu. Jai Nityanand Prabhu ki jai. Jai Raghunath Das Goswami ki jai.
Jai.
Hari Hari Bol. Today is the 7th. I would like to tell some katha of Bhajan Rahasya. I won't take your too much time because I am describing Bhajan Rahasya daily. So performing the Bhajan Rahasya studying, so we have reached to the sixth Yam Sadhan, where Sayankalin Bhajan. I was telling about the Sayankalin Bhajan, the Bhav. And the sixth close shloka was quoted there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur described there. Nayanam Galashudharya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was saying, "Hey Bhagwan, when I will get the day that chanting your holy name, the tear will come out from eyes like Ganga and Yamuna. My throat will be choked. So goosebumps will be on my body. So these all are the symptoms of love, which is called Ashtasattvik Bhav. There are 8 kinds of Sattvik Bhav, which is called Romanchakam, Pashru. These all symptoms seems to the sadhak. When love manifested in the heart of sadhaks, all these kinds of symptoms seems. So there are stages of that. When Ashtasattvik Vikar, there is a mystery in that. One is Dhurumai, Dwari, Sudipta. So these five, I have already described all these things many times. When one and two, the Sattvic Vikar manifest in heart, this is like Dhurumai. It's just like flame, smoke. It's just like a smoke. This is called Dhurumayat. When one or two Sattvic Vikar manifest, this is called Dhurumayat. When Dhurumai Jalit, the flame of fire is coming, and two, three Sattvic Vikars when come, that is called Jalit. Deepta.
Illuminated.
Yes, the outside. So this is called Deepta. When four or five Vikars comes. So, three, four Sattvic Vikars came at one time. And Udipta, when four to five Vikars comes. So, this is called Udipta. And the Sudipta Mahabhav, at the one time, Ashtasattvic Vikars. All the Ashtasattvic Vikars manifested. This is called Sudipta. Sudipta Mahabhav. This Sudipta Mahabhav only can see in Radharani, Mahaprabhu, and Radharani. No one or others, we can see others, because Sarvamattacharya, he is so much intelligent. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entered in Jagannath Puri first time after taking sannyas, so Mahaprabhu was thinking, "I am Radha, now I am going to meet with my beloved Krishna." So he got the mode of separation there. So he thought that after a long time I'm going to meet my beloved Krishna. So he was going to embrace Lord Jagannath. Then all the Prajari came in and stopped him that time. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was fell down that time. And Mahaprabhu completely fainted that time. Pujari was thinking he is mad. Maybe you have heard or seen some pictures.
He came to take darshan to Lord Vishnu. जगन्नाथ चैतन्य महाप्रभु है माने कि दारू ब्रह्मा और चैतन्य गौर है दारू भटा चैतन्य सुता भगवान है पढ़ लेते दारू भटा चैतन्य ने नोटिस है सोमा स्वेत गानी बड़े लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु है दारू भटा चैतन्य जब भी सुताई I saw, I read Shastra. God has been seeing this type of symptom. First time, Mahaprayoga, Mahamaya, Sarvataja, he did not understand the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Supreme Personality of God Himself. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they combined along with Venkata Raja Krishna. And what does he get? Because Maya se wo samajh nahi paya. Ye Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sang Krishna. Bata Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sang Radha Bhav Kanti Ungikar Karke aaya. Keval gyan ki drishti se
महाभारत
But still, he is thinking, maybe he is one Mahapurusha. Actually, this is also Mahapurusha. Srimad Bhagavat Kuru Sukri, Tapta Asuda Sura Sunaradhira Chundra Nishtarata Vajasa Jadvar Dharam Mayam Mundi Chishtra Madhavam Spandi Mahapurusha Charanadhi Vendram Suddha Sarasati. Given the expression, explanation. Because Sarvabhatta Chacha, he is thinking, maybe he is some Mahapurusha, meaning great person. But here Mahapurusha means his one. Srimad Bhagavat Mahapurusha means Saint Bhagavan. Because in this Kali Yuga, who will be appear? In this Kali Yuga, Saint Bhagavan recognized. He is Saint Bhagavan. Nine rishis and Navajagendra and Nimi Maharaj. Nimi Maharaj asked this question. In this Kali Yuga, how who is our personal deity? How no? Deva. That time two shlokas recited by some among the nine rishis.
Nimi Maharaj.
तप्ता सुदेशुद्ध सुरिष्ठ राजलक्ष्मी धर्मिष्ठार जुगचसा जदगार वर्ण माया निगम देवीसितम नदावदो बंदी महापुरुषी चरणार्जन और सो यह रीड दिस वर्ड महापुरुष महापुरुष मिल्स है क्यों दक्षाई तीन पुरुष हैं इतने पुरुष हैं जो सृष्ट है कितने पुरुष हैं
तीन पुरुष
कौन कौन तीन पुरुष
गर्भोदक्षाई
क्षीर इनका भी श्रेष्ठ जो है वही श्रेष्ठ कौन
कृष्ण
भगवान कृष्ण है और वही का मेरे कहीं भी तत्व सरमट्टा ने कि मुझसे जो शब्द निकला है वो सीधा सरस्वती सोचने लगे कोई ग्रेट पर्सन है किंतु चक्र जी यहाँ पर जो वर्णन करते जा रहे हैं जब उसके हृदय में प्रेम और भाव
So what's my mean to say? When somebody's heart manifested love, love is manifesting somebody's heart. So he got these kinds of symptoms. So in this chapter, it's very nicely described everything that how Sadhak he performing bhajan he get this all kinds of bhav. Sadhan bhakti, bhav bhakti and prema bhakti. There are three kinds of bhakti. From shraddha to asakti. Sadhan bhakti. From shraddha to asakti. This is called sadhan bhakti. And after that bhav bhakti. And after that prema bhakti. What is the object of sadhan bhakti? How we can get the bhav? And the object of bhav bhakti is how we can get love. How we can get the bhav bhakti? Why the performing sadhana you cannot get the bhav? What is bhav? Bhav is kripa siddha. Bhav is only possible by the bestow of the mercy. So for getting this bhav, we need the kripa. So this kripa, this mercy is kind, two kinds of mercy. Sadhana Vinniveshvija. While performing sadhan, then gradually the heart will be pure, and by the causeless mercy of Bhagwan and by the causeless mercy of devotees, you will get this bhav. And it seems that somebody didn't perform any sadhan and he got spontaneous all these kinds of bhav in his heart. So we should understand that maybe he has done all the sadhan in his previous life. Anyhow, it was stopped. And then again in his heart everything is happened, just like Narad Rishi. He did the mercy to whom? Mrigari. There is a hunter, Mrigari. So he bestowed his mercy upon him. Narad Rishi bestowed his mercy to Dhruv Maharaj. Many people. So it is possible by the mercy of Bhagwan and Bhagwan Bhakt. So it is very rare to get the mercy of Bhagwan directly, because in the Gita Bhagwan is saying Samam Sarva Bhuteshu. I'm neutral. So I am neutral for everybody. Nobody is my friend, nobody is my enemy. That's why Bhagwat, the mercy of Bhagwan is very rare. But Bhakti Kripa, the mercy of the devotees, is easy. So who the devotee will bestow his mercy upon? The Kanishna Adhikari cannot bestow his mercy upon because he doesn't have this kinds of quality. Because he doesn't have Adhikar. What is the symptoms of Kanishna? He will do the worship of Hari. They do the archan. But so they don't know how to treat with the devotees. So being the abhav of lacking of Tattva Gyan, being that lacking of Tattva Gyan, Kanishna Adhikari cannot bestow his mercy to anyone. He is not able to discriminate that who is a devotee, who is non-devotee. That's why the Kanishna Adhikari cannot bestow his mercy. And Uttam Adhikari, they will bestow his mercy or not, because they want bestow his mercy, or because we see is the all the Uttam Adhikari are engaging himself in the service of Lord. They are always engaged in the service of Bhagwan. We see is the all the Uttam Bhava, they are serving to the Lord. How they are serving? They are by their bhava, by their feelings. That's why Uttam Bhagavat, they don't mercy. So they very humbly will say, please bestow your mercy upon me. and we will see that they all are serving to the Lord. Whenever Uttam Bhagavat see anything, so they get stimulation in his heart. Whenever they see the little mountain, so they think this is good Raj Govardhan, and they started crying. So Uttam Bhagavat, these are the symptoms of Uttam Bhagavat. Whenever they see the little river, so they seems it is Yamuna. And in the Yamuna, they always engage in the service of Radha Krishna. Whenever they see the little forest, they so they seems it is Vrindavan. They remember the past, Vrindavan. So we haven't seen the Vrindavan now. Have you seen Vrindavan? When? After some time, you will see the beautiful Vrindavan at the both side of Yamuna. There are many kinds of trees are established there, where the Madhumakhi Chhatta bees collected there. It's all described in the Shastras. So what's my mean to say, the Uttam Bhagavat, they cannot see this gross things. So wherever they see, they remember the past time, and they always cry, sees all these things. Lokavachya. Being very humble, they cry for Bhagwan. Sometimes they laugh. Sometimes they're rolling on the ground. So how they will mercy Madhyamadhikari? Who will bestow you his mercy? Madhyamadhikari. There are four kinds of symptoms of Madhyamadhikari. What are that? Ishwari. Love in the love for Krishna, Ishwar, and Maitri, friendly. So they have friendship nature towards Bhakta. So they have so much merciful nature and Upeksha, who are so much envious in their heart, who criticize Guru and Vaishnav. So what they So they upekshali neglect them. Neglect. So this is the qualification of Madhyamakari, because they have the adhikar for best is mercy. Uttam Adhikari, there are three stages of Uttam Adhikari. Bhagavat Parsha Deha Prapta, Nirdhuta Kasai, Murchit Kasai. So these are the three categories of Uttam Adhikari. Bhagavat Parsha Deha, like Narad Rishi. I have told you that Narad Rishi has best his mercy after getting the association of so many devotees. So when Narad Rishi best his mercy to the devotees, they get the love. They got the Bhagavat Parsha Deha. And second, Nirduta Kashaya, who doesn't have any kinds of impurity in their heart. They are pure. They are just like Sukhdev Goswami. So taking the darshan of Sukhdev Goswami, all the wild animals drawn into the love of ocean. They were crying that time. It is described in the Bhagavatam. So after him, behind him, his father Vyasdev was chasing him. But Sukadev Goswami didn't see back, and he got the sound back. So he when he was saying ha putra ha po, so he was getting returned back. Oh, who is your son? Who is your son? just like we heard the story of Nimai Sanyas. When Mahaprabhu was taken sannyas, he went away. So after the Sachi Mata, she woke up when she cried. Sachi Mata was crying that Nimai. And she was getting the back sound like 999. No. So the Nimai Sanyas is very pathetic. People used to cry for the entering in the land of Sitaji. When Sitaji went entered into the land, when you see the Sanyas story of or hear see the Sanyas story of Nimai, you will be crying. All the Pashu Pakshis was crying that time when Sachi Mata was saying like Nimai, and that sound was coming back 999. So the context we were discussing, and the Murchit Kasai, mercy, kripa, kaun kar sakta hai? So by the taking his darshan, all his heart get the love. Everybody gets the love in his heart. Murchit Kasai, and the Murchit Kasai, their heart is pure, everything is there. They have love still, but still they have little a sattvic bhag in their heart. Just like Narishi, when he got the birth in the form of Dasi Putra, he was telling his life story to Vyasdev. Vyasdev, at this Chaturmas time, so I used to take the darshan of many saintly person with my mother, but I have so much affection towards my towards the Sant Mahatma, and all the saint persons, they bestowed their own mercy upon me. They were giving the uchit prasad to me, and they have gave the mantra to me. So the sat sadhu, the pure devotee, what they want? So in the Narada Shiksha, so they see who are listening our katha very nicely, very attentively. They doesn't want lakh or crore rupees. So are the true saints, when they will be pleased, when who listen their katha. This is true. Narishi was telling his life story. Narishi was saying the time wherever the Sant Mahatma, where they used to sit there, I was hearing the katha of that Sant Mahatma very attentively, and I served a little of Sant Mahatma. I was just 5 years old, Narishi was saying. And at that time, seeing to me in this way, all the Sant Mahatma was praised to me, and they gave me their uchisht prasad. I got the remnants of Sant Mahatma. And then Sant Mahatma, amongst them Sant Mahatma, one person gave to me that mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. And Narishi was saying that I would like to stay with the Sant Mahatma, but at the evening, my widow mother, she used to carry me and take me at home. So I was praying to Bhagwan, hey, obstacle. So my mother is the obstacle in this path. Hey Prabhu, I would like to get the association of always Sant Mahatma. He was thinking like that and he was praying to Bhagwan. And one day Bhagwan listened his katha. Every day you pray to Thakurji, one day Thakurji will listen to you. Jaru sunenge. They will listen to your prayer for sure. Every day if you pray to Lord by the heart, even if you have the material desire, still Bhagwan will that fulfill that. Every day you will ask to Bhagwan, oh, get this, go away. Bhagwan will listen to you. In this way, Narada Rishi was saying, I wanted to be with Sant Mahatma. But at the time, my mother used to carry me at my home. And one day, what happened? My mother, at the time, at the evening time, the Godali Leela, she was doing, taking milk from the cow. In the meantime, what happened? Black serpent came and
white.
नाथ जी बोले मेरे माँ तो शरीर छोड़ दिया और मेरे अच्छा है आज से कोई मुझे रुकेगा नहीं है संत महात्मा के संग.
So after 4 months, when the 4 months end up, so her mother was died and Maharishi went to that saintly persons and visited all the pilgrimages with them. It is very nicely described, and I got the eagerness in my heart that I will get the Bhagwan. And one day there is a aerial sound came. So just like a light, Bhagwan gave me darshan, and I got the darshan. I was fainted that time. Even I don't know what time, how long I fainted on the ground. When I got the back consciousness, when I got my consciousness back, so I was reminding us all the darshan. That darshan, I was not able to forget that. Shankar Chakrapada Gadmadhari Bhagwan Narayan. So I got so much pleasure in my heart. The Brahmavadi, they would like to submerge into the Brahma. So they are just would like to submerge into the Brahma Jyoti. So if they take the darshan of Bhagwan, so what to say about that? So there was too much pleasure in the darshan of Bhagwan. We cannot describe that. Just like that. So we came back to the katha. So I was praying again and again towards Bhagwan, and the aerial sound came that time. Hey Narad. Hey Narad, when you will give up this body, this panchbhautik body, so when you will come into the transcendental body and come to my abode, then Narashi at the time, so he was getting, his eagerness was increasing day by day. How can I get the darshan of Bhagwan? Then Narashi was thinking in his mind that how I want to stay in this world, one mein. So where is the bhakti resides? In the one forest. So that time he decided to stay in the forest. Kasai. So this is called the Murchit Kasai. But he is Uttam Bhagavata. These three are Uttam Bhagavata. I have given you the example. Bhagavat Parshad, Prapt Narashi, and Sukadeva Goswami, he is Uttam Bhagavat. Madhyam, but he is Uttam Madhyam. And then Dasiputra, Narad. He got the birth in the Dasiputra, so he is also Murchit Kasai. He is Uttam Kanishth. They all are Uttam Bhagavat, he is Uttam Kanishth. So taking darshan of this kind of Uttam Bhagavat, you will get the bhakti. That's why Narottam Das was speaking. So taking a darshan of Mahaprabhu so long, and he got the love. So this kind of uttam uttam Mahabhagavat. So how they are taking darshan of Bhagavat? There is a question arise. How we, after so previous birth Sukriti, after so many previous Sukriti, birth Sukriti. So all this katha is described here. That's why Gurudev is writing here. But by the mercy of and I told there are nine symptoms. There are 9 external symptoms of bhav and 3 internal. 3 internal symptoms of bhav: shanti, internal. 3 are internal symptoms: anukulya, Krishna, Krishna, sohard, sohard, Bhagavat, Bhagavat Prapti Avilasha. Yes, Bhagavat Prapti Avilasha. There are 3 kinds of Avilasha: Bhagavat Prapti Avilasha, Swahardha Avilasha, Avilasha, and Anukul Avilasha. That somebody is performing, wants to perform bhajan in the Vatsal mode. So the servant of the Vatsali mode, Maitri Bhav, so they must have the friendship nature with that person. And somebody is Dasya Patra, so Ratha Patra, they must get the this kind of friendship nature of these kinds of people. And the Sakhya Bhav, Subal Shridham, they must have the friendship nature of these kinds of people. And the Madhurya, Gopi, and Radha Lalita Vishakha and others gopis, they have, must have the friendship nature with them. Avilasha, Bhagavad Prapti Avilasha, Anukula Avilasha. Yes. Somebody has to serve the Radha Rani, so he has to take the shelter of Roop Manjari. Roop Manjari. So they has to make a friendship with the Roop Manjari. How you will get the nature that how you can keep the friendship with Roop Manjari? So you have to glorify their katha, kirtan, Shri Roop Manjari Pada. They must have this kinds of feelings in their heart. So because under the guidance of Roop Manjari, they have to serve Srimati Radhikarani. Because under the guidance of Roop Manjari, they can get the service of Radharani. So that's why our Raghunatha Goswami, they are praying to Roop Manjari. So you must have the friendships whose feelings you know, and you would like to get the feelings of that person. So this is a specialty in sadhan. You must get the sangha. You must get the association of your sajatiya bhakta, same like-minded person. Sato means Sant Mahatma, Var means Shrestha. So how must they? Sajatiya means like-minded. They must have the, you must associate the people like-minded. Whose and their internal, the heart. So their heart is filled up and colored with the Krishna Prem. Chatusama. Bharav. Whose heart is full of colored with the Chatusama. Chatusama is Aguru, Chandan, Kumkum, and Kapoor. Camphor. Camphor is last one. Aguru. Are you? There are four kinds of ingredients like Aguru and all that is called Chatusam. Camphor, Aguru, Kumkum, and one more. Aguru, Chandan, Kumkum, or Camphor. Camphor. Camphor, yes. Kumkum bola, Chandan bola, Aguru bola. They have to mix up the in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is very described. What is Chatusam? Aguru, Chandan, Kumkum, Camphor. Chatusam. Chatusam. What is my meaning to say? There's a meaning too. It's all the same in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. What is camphor? I will tell you later, tomorrow. If I tell you everything in one day, then you will cannot understand, cannot digest. So what's my mean to say? Whose heart is full of colored with the love of Srimati Radhikar. I am telling whose heart his heart is full of colored by the Chatusam of Radha Rani's love. So they should get the association of that kinds of devotees. Okay, kya bola? Tell me what I told you. Ranjit. Prem ke dwara Ranjit. You have heard the first time and you told very nicely, and when you heard this 2-3 times, you will be perfect in this. If you heard first time and if you heared again and again, so you will be perfect in that. Is it true or not? That's why I told you about Chatusam. I will ask you tomorrow. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita it is mentioned. I am not saying myself. Chandan, Aguru, Kumkum, Kapoor, Camphor. Karpur, Gauram, Kiranavataram, Sunsarataram. I will tell you what kind of these four things. Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol, Jai Ho. Your mobile is
because there are many viewers, 1,000 viewers.